गो।
हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी थीसिस ऑफ वरदान, हु इज वर्किंग ऑन द स्पेशल एंड टेम्पोरल थर्मल मैप्स। सो ओवर टू यू वरदान।
Swami. So the topic of the thesis is spatial and temporal thermal maps for naturally ventilated indoor spaces. Natural ventilation is one of the most effective passive strategies, not just from the viewpoint of energy saving, but also from the perspective of health, comfort, and well-being. As per US Energy Information in India, only 2% households have an air conditioner today, but it is increasing at 20% rate annually. With air conditioning industry penetrating into the Indian society, the need to address advantage of operating buildings with natural ventilation needs to be raised to retain the passive character that already exists in the society. Analogy can be drawn from the way technological advancements happened in the field of electrical lighting and had questioned the need of daylight. After all, what would be the use of a building with the most efficient HVAC system or a low energy cooling system if a design opportunity to take advantage of freely available natural ventilation had been ignored? For natural ventilation to work well, it is important to design for it in more granularity, that is, ensuring maximum comfort possible over the entire flow plate across the year. This is because even if one part of the flow plate is not comfortable enough at any given point, it will quickly be turned into an air-conditioned space that defeats the purpose. Hence, understanding the spatial and temporal characteristics of operative temperature is critical to ensure a successful natural ventilation design. Hence, understanding spatial and temporal characteristics of operative temperature is critical. Brager and Baker in 2009 conducted a web-based survey in 12 mixed-mode buildings and compared the benchmarking data. This survey focuses on seven areas of indoor environmental performance, thermal comfort being one of them. As per the results, 41% dissatisfied people, the prime reason of dissatisfaction was that the area is hotter or colder than other areas, or lack of air movement. Thus, spatial non-uniformity is one of the top reasons for thermal dissatisfaction in buildings. So, with this background and hypothesis, a literature review was conducted to understand more about the non-uniformity in an indoor environment. Convective museum is one of hypothetical projects of Philip Ram. The museum is defined by two poles of heat at 16 and 20 degrees Celsius as per the requirements of the program. Convective museum communicates a powerful idea that one might design a building by placing a program in relation to the set of given environments. Newsham in 1992 developed Fenestra, which divided feet of the six sides of the room into nine surfaces, establishing a matrix of nine possible locations that an occupant could inhabit to make themselves most comfortable. Newsham illustrated that adaptive response of occupants moving around a single room can have a large influence on comfort. He also said that potential of this adaptive range is likely much greater over a whole floor plate because of different orientation, a wider range of microclimates emerging from different climatic and geometric variables. Chapter 12 of book Environmental Diversity in Architecture by Twin Schemers talks about the fieldwork that monitored thermal conditions in four houses for 6 months. It was found that the occupants exploit the spatial diversity while utilizing them for various functions. An interesting hypothetical situation was made where if a subject is free and willing to move in these spaces, he or she could achieve a PPD of almost zero. Thus, it can be inferred that thermal diversity in space could exist because of various reasons. But another way to look at it is a bottom-up approach to exploit thermal diversity in space and make the design decisions based on spatial and temporal variations. Second part of the literature review talks about the current methodology and tools to calculate and integrate these parameters to generate high resolution temporal and station maps. Most of the building simulation tools or methodology perform analysis at a zonal level first. This is done to understand the global comfort conditions of the building. This type of analysis can tell over the course of a year what the thermal conditions are for each zone as a whole. But a second analysis at a final level is also required. This may be a final analysis using human body model or a spatially resolved model of the room. Hence, we can see a gradual shift from control volume towards discretized analysis, which intend to map comfort in spatial temporal ways. Parallelly, many new types of indices have been proposed which aim at long-term evaluation of general thermal comfort conditions in a building and have been reviewed by Carlucci. These indices for long-term evaluation of thermal comfort conditions in a building are mainly single values which summarize a variety of comfort conditions encountered in the various thermal zones of a building over a certain period of time and are useful in the design phase to derive an optimization process. Further, all the recent studies are analyzed from four points: analysis method, scale of focus, spatial output, and temporal output. Most of the methodologies have been derived for air conditioned spaces and majorly covers only two parameters of the study. Two studies, one by Levitt and another by Jakubik, intends to capture thermal diversity for natural ventilation spaces, but both of them are just pointed space using SO network model to predict the impact of air velocity. Hence, calculating air velocity distribution only in point in time or point in space and not both together. Recently, methodologies like Pan-Climatic Humans by McKay for 2015 produces thermal maps for operative temperature considering air temperature and mean radiant temperature both spatially and temporally, and has been packaged in the form of an open source tool as well. So the literature review shows that the most methodology to plot thermal maps or operative temperature exists for air conditioned spaces and do not consider air velocity in the calculation of operative temperature. Hence, a methodology is needed to map spatial and temporal diversity of parameters that affect comfort for natural ventilated spaces by incorporating the impact of air velocity in both thermal, spatial and temporal aspects. Which brings us to the purpose statement of the research, which is to develop spatial, which is multi-point data instead of single-point data, and temporal distribution maps of operative temperature by developing a methodology which amalgamates CFD with thermal simulation. The objective is to obtain air velocity, air temperature, and mean radiant temperature over a range of period and spatially to account for its impact on varied capability of a point in that space to provide comfort in natural ventilation scenario. The third part of the literature review was to understand the comfort parameters and derive methodologies to generate operative temperature plots. Thermal comfort is defined as condition of mind that is satisfaction with the thermal environment is expressed. The definition is easy to understand, but it is hard to express by mathematical relation because it is required to consider number of environmental and personal parameters like culture, behavior, weight, race, etc. But the basic environmental parameters like air temperature, mean radiant temperature, and air velocity define the environmental thermal state and can be expressed in a mathematical expression. There are many methods for calculating operative temperature as can be seen in the figure on the right, but this thesis focuses on the formula as mentioned in ISO 7726, Ergonomics of Thermal Environment Instruments for measuring physical quantities will be used. The reason for this formula mentioned in ISO standard is that it explicitly considers the impact of air velocity in operative temperature. The formula also reduces to the average of air temperature and mean radiant temperature for the cases where air velocity is less than 0.1 meter per second, as mentioned in the ASHRAE standard 55. This slide explains the methodology for calculating the air temperature. Most of the methodology and research towards spatial and temporal mapping of comfort variables take average take air temperature as a base temperature and is calculated using building simulation engine, assuming well mixed indoor conditions, and captures the diversity in the space because of other parameters. CMAP simulates a single mean indoor air temperature for the zone and calculated the spatial distribution of thermal comfort based on mean radiant temperature. Same with the indoor microclimatic map, which calculates the average zone air temperature using energy class, and the same value is used for all the points. Thus, this methodology has been adopted to calculate air temperature, and same air based temperature will be used in the entire zone. Radiant temperature from long wave radiation of interior surfaces is expressed as a spatial average of the temperature of surfaces surrounding the occupant weighted by their view factor with respect to the occupant. To obtain view factor, McKay validated a methodology that uses ray trace method, which generates vectors by the means of tracking the sky dome from all the points in the space. The view factor is calculated using the expression in the bottom right, where B is true or false value for whether an intersection was successful at and A is the area of the given trigonometric patch, A naught being the total area of the sphere. The individual vector intersections are summed over the whole sphere to determine the view factor to a given surface. The methodology also intends to consider the impact of direct solar radiation, radiant temperature from shortwave, and diffuse solar radiation expressed as an adjustment to shortwave radiation, as an adjustment to shortwave mean radiant temperature. McKay also coded a methodology to calculate solar adjusted mean radiant temperature based on solar cal method proposed by Arens in 2015. Traditionally, in order to determine the solar adjusted mean radiant temperature, a radiation study of the human body is performed, and this then produces an effective radiant field through the following formula. ERF is the shortwave radiation plus and is calculated using variables like solar radiation, geometric coefficients of human body, sky view factor, fraction of body visible from the sky dome, etc. Unlike solar cal method, McKay validated his methodology wherein he proposes to reduce the human geometry to only 9 points while calculating solar radiation of the fraction of body visible to direct radiation. This drastically reduces the computation time to obtain solar adjusted mean radiant temperature across the space over the range of period of time. Indoor thermal comfort is to a large extent is influenced by the airflow behavior in the space. To reduce the number of environmental inputs and reduce the computation time, point forces have been ignored in many studies that use CFD to analyze airflow in interior natural ventilation space. Primarily because of the small temperature between indoor and outdoor environments, and to reduce the requirement of computing time and capacity, and to overall improve the efficiency of solving other equations. Thus, incompressible and isothermal flow of energy, the equation can be dropped only to mass and linear momentum equations. Thus, the number of environmental inputs reduced to only air velocity and wind direction, and internal wall surfaces are as adiabatic. While the focus of this study is on the indoor thermal comfort analysis, it is worth mentioning the maturing body of literature and range of thermal comfort analysis tools for outdoor thermal comfort analysis. A methodology was developed to obtain outdoor thermal comfort over a range of periods in Singapore, where 9 representative weather types created using K-type data clustering to cluster applied on the basis of 6 environmental variables. Similar strategy has been adopted by us to bring the weather data on the basis of airspeed and direction, thereby reducing the number of CFD runs and interpolating that data back to it in 60 hours. RNG K epsilon ramp turbulence model will be used as it has the best overall performance compared to other models in terms of accuracy, computing efficiency, and robustness. Quality control criteria like grid independence and convergence have been understood from the literature, and boundary conditions will be defined as per cost. Action 72. Rhinoceros along with grasshopper will be used as it includes Many open source libraries like Ladybug use special environmental plugins for Grasshopper and will be helpful in creating such maps. Honeybee has the ability to connect with validated simulation engines such as Synology Plus via OpenStudio for thermal simulation, and Butterfly, which is a plugin and a Python library to create and run advanced CFD simulations using OpenFOAM. Azhar Academy in Hyderabad has been selected as the building to be used for this methodology. It is a 3,500 square meter institutional building. A lecture room on the ground floor has been selected for the analysis and has the orientation as north-south. A multi-zone, the proposed methodology will the upper and the multi-zone model using energy Honeybee has been created. The upper and adjacent classrooms were also modeled as seen in the figure as separate zones. And the input parameters for the envelope and the way the window operates has been shown on the table in the right. Following are the results for surface temperature on 2nd May. The eastern exposed site has highest indoor surface temperature of 44 degrees Celsius. Indoor surface temperature for all the surfaces for all the 290 hours were extracted. This was followed by view factor calculation. The view vector for every point are generated, which will be used to calculate humidity temperature. A mesh size of 0.5 meter by 0.5 meter has been taken for this lecture space, giving us a total of 390 grid points. The figure above shows the distribution of the solar adjusted mean radiant temperature, and it can be observed that the eastern zone of the room experience high radiant temperatures compared to the other parts of the room. McCabe microclimatic map tool has been used to extract the solar mean radiant temperatures. The mean radiant temperature for 2nd May shows a trend of a higher mean radiant temperature on the eastern side from 8 in the morning. The MRT increases from 35 degrees to 41 degrees on the eastern side of the room till 10 a.m. And during the afternoon, the mean radiant temperature is highest from the southern side. Due to higher solar altitude angle in Hyderabad, there is no direct sun penetration inside the space within this time frame because of shading and facade elements. Hence, thermal simulation model shows physically realistic results. The air temperature at the simulation timestamp was 36 degrees, and the same temperature has been used throughout the space. The geometry was modeled in rhinoceros, neglecting the wall thicknesses. The window area has been reduced to 50% as the window configuration consists of sliding shutters. The classroom above it and the adjacent ones have also been included. The wind tunnel has been created using the best practices, and a box-shaped wind tunnel was constructed with dimensions as shown in the figure on the right, and these dimensions are in respect to the building geometry. By decoupling the CFD with energy equations, the environmental inputs of CFD boundary condition reduce to only air velocity and wind direction. Thus, both wind speed and direction were studied in concurrence for all 2920 hours. As discussed earlier, for the wind speeds less than 0.1 meter per second, the operative temperature is an average of air temperature and mean radiant temperature, and air speed doesn't have an impact. Hence, the wind roll diagram has been divided into 8 segments. Further mesh dependent study was conducted to obtain grid independent solutions. To verify and report grid independence, refined mesh were created by increasing the refinement level of the building geometric surfaces by a factor of 1 in each Cartesian direction while keeping the number of divisions of the background mesh constant. Grid independent results started to obtain from iteration 3. Air velocity across two sections of the geometry were plotted. Hence, iteration 3 with surface refinement level 4.4 was taken forward to conduct CFD for all the scenarios. Four CFD runs were conducted to extract air velocity distribution for all the bins. Result of bin 17 with inlet air velocity 6 meter per second and 180 degree wind direction have been shown. The solution was ran for 600 iterations to ensure the results stabilized, and convergence criteria of 10 raised to the power minus 4 was achieved for air velocity, pressure, and epsilon. The probe utility of OpenFOAM allows to generate grid points of specified dimensions. The grid point picks up the air velocity of the nearest cell in the mesh, and air velocity distribution of desired spatial resolution can be achieved. CFD results show are the CFD results are of wind 17 with wind direction 180 and wind speed 6 meters per second. On analyzing the results of all the 24 CFD simulations, a relationship was found between air velocity distribution across every grid point with the inlet air speed from the same wind direction. Indoor air velocity distribution for wind 11, 17, and 23 has been shown in the figure on the left. On the left. The wind direction in all these cases is 180 degrees, and with the wind inlet speed as 2, 4, and 6 respectively. It can be observed that indoor air velocity increases proportionately as the inlet wind speed increases, and hence a proportionate relationship has been found. Thus, to reduce the number of CFD runs, wind factor can be calculated for every grid point across by dividing the magnitude of air velocity across all the grid points by inlet air speed at a given reference site. Once the wind factors are obtained across all the grid points, air velocity distribution can be obtained for every grid point at any wind speed, but from the same wind direction. Wind factor calculated using CFD results of wind 5 with direction 180 and wind speed 2 meters per second. After the wind factors were obtained for all the grid points, magnitude of air velocity was calculated for inlet air velocity 4 and 6 meters per second and compared with the wind 11 and 17 having the same wind direction and speed. The wind speed calculated using the wind factor method showed very close agreement compared to the actual CFD results as shown in the figure on the right. This study was done for all the winds and similar results have been found. That is, the reason behind this relationship is because the assumption of isothermal airflow and incompressible and steady state CFD simulations which use RHG K epsilon trans turbulence model. Hence, the number of CFD runs can be reduced to the number of directions or segments the windows is split in. Air temperature, mean radiant temperature, and air velocity data across all the 394 grid points for 2920 occupancy hours was extracted. Conditional statements were scripted in Microsoft Excel to link air velocity distribution of all the 2920 hours with their respective bins, and data for all the three parameters was streamlined in similar format. An operative temperature was calculated across all the grid points. The image shows air temperature, mean radiant temperature, and operative temperature for 2nd May 10 a.m. The indoor air temperature is 37 degrees Celsius, which has been interpolated along all the grid points. Mean radiant temperature shows the impact of high surface temperature on the eastern wall because of the direct solar radiation falling on the exposed side. And the air velocity distribution map represents 42. Represents wind 42 with inlet airspeed 3.2 meters per second and wind direction as 272 degrees. The operative temperature plot indicates the reduction in impact of mean radiant temperature in the south and the eastern zone of the room because of the high air velocity distribution in these areas. Two types of operative maps were generated, one with the conventional methodology of simply averaging out mean radiant temperature and air temperature, whereas the other one considering the impact of air velocity distribution across all the grid points, and these both were compared against each other. The conventional methodology, thus it can be seen that the conventional methodology predicts the space to be overheated, and thus by integrating CFD results with thermal simulation, the impact of air velocity on reducing the operative temperature can be observed. Image on the left is an operative temperature plot considering all the three comfort parameter variables from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. Once the operative temperature for every grid point across the hours were found, conditional statements to assign value 1 for the times when operative temperature was less than 30 degrees Celsius or else 0 was scripted in Microsoft Excel. These values for each grid point was averaged across the temporal range to obtain percentage of time when a condition is met. A spatial plot was generated that represents the capability of each grid point to provide comfort. The map brings out the thermal non-uniformity in the space over a range of meters. It can be observed that the southern zone of the lecture room has the lowest percentage of power for temperatures below less than 30 degrees Celsius because of the direct solar radiation. Eastern zone has lower percentage compared to the west because of the exposed wall. And there's a difference of almost 10% between the east and the west wall. This data can be further manipulated to exhibit thermal diversity of the space as per the desired threshold values. Further, the calculation methodology for air temperature and mean radiant temperature has already been picked from the literature, which is validated. In order to simplify the CFD simulation as an assumption to ignore buoyant forces, considering isothermal airflow has been made. The methodology to validate this has been shown in the figure. 7 point in time data points have been selected from the climate file having the same wind direction for low, medium and high wind speeds to study the impact of buoyant forces across all the ranges of air velocity. Magnitude of air velocity will be obtained using CFD, considering heat transfer equations this time to capture the impact of buoyant forces for all these 7 data points. Subsequently, operative temperature will be calculated for these points in time and will be compared against the operative temperature already obtained using the CFD simulations considering isothermal air. The assumption of ignoring buoyant forces was thus validated. The proposed methodology shows an average deviation of 1% and an absolute deviation of 7% in the grid points compared to a non-isothermal airflow when the indoor ventilation is enhanced because of external environmental parameters like air speed, sky cover and solar radiation. For the environmental condition where buoyant forces are less, like high wind speed, average the average deviation is less than 0.6% with just 4% absolute deviation. Thus, complex natural ventilation strategies like assisted stack, which enhance the buoyant forces in space and hence will increase the deviation. Thus, this methodology can be used for single-sided cross ventilation assisted by simple stack like ventilators. To conclude, the study proposes a methodology and splits the workflow into thermal simulation to calculate air temperature and MRT and CFD to calculate air velocity. The study proposes validated methodology from the literature. The air temperature is a simple interpolation of the energy plus output, and mean radiant temperature is calculated by multiplication of U factor for air stated point by the surface temperature. The impact of direct solar radiation has been incorporated into the literature. To increase the computation time of CFD and decrease the number of CFD runs, an assumption of isothermal airflow has been made and buoyancy-driven assisted ventilation has been ignored. With these assumptions, the number of CFD runs reduced only to the number of segments the wind rows is split into, and thereafter wind factors can be obtained across the space. The thermal map helps us to achieve thermally diverse and richer design environment as they enable designers to fully understand the spatial and temporal implication of design on thermal comfort. The limitations and recommendations for the future study is that the methodology currently addresses only isothermal airflow, but it can be further developed to incorporate buoyancy driven and assisted ventilation, which would allow other natural ventilation passive strategies like stack to be analyzed. Also, this methodology has been derived from CFD and thermal models, which show physically realistic results, but it should be validated with measurements and real experiments. Thank you.